I'm sure you have lots of experience putting these things on.
I'm not really. Is that good?
Is that why you wear two shirts, one for each camera?
Exactly. Are you wanting to appear? Have you seen Trump at War?
Your film. I should say yes now, but I haven't. So.
Well, no. I'm gonna send you a link tonight.
Okay.
This is not a persuasion film. It's a piece of propaganda, right? I consider propaganda to be positive, but.
Errol Moore says, and with respect to you, the permission to hate seems to be a really big part of what Steve Bannon offered to voters. Hate black people, hate Hispanics, hate Muslims, hate. Hate is energizing for a lot of people. That was his interpretation of you after spending a lot of time with you.
You have to watch the film and see that. I don't think that's true at all.
Some of the people you're doing business with here in Europe are, you know, far right, sometimes quite extreme, sometimes we've got links to...
Like Orban or who?
Like Philippe de Winter, who you had a meeting with in London?
No, he just came, that was a general dinner.
But does it concern you that Philippe de Winter is like commemorated former SS collaborators?
No, that, I said that kind of stuff is not going to be tolerated in the movement. We were very upfront with that, right? So he just came to the dinner. That was a general dinner. We had, you know, a number of people there.
What about Kent Ekeroth in Sweden? I mean, he has been ostracized by the Sweden Democrats. He's not even on their list of parliamentary candidates.
He came to the introductory dinner too.
Who's the other person at the dinner?
Yeah, I mean, there's like 15 or 20 people at the dinner.
I mean, people will find it deeply offensive, particularly Jews who live in Europe.
Jews who lived in Italy. Hang on, Michael happens to be Jewish. Michael's Jewish.
Let me just say what Errol Morris said. He said, Steve Bannon will doubtlessly say that his remarks were not anti-Semitic, but I would respectfully disagree. He knew what he was doing. He's suggesting that you're doing dog whistle anti-Semitism here. That's your modus operandi.
I just disagree with Errol on that.
Is the term globalist an anti-Semitic?
Absolutely not.
Coded anti-Semitic?
No,
I mean, there are people who would argue that it is. George Soros? I mean, that is widely accepted as an anti-Semitic trope. The suggestion that George Soros is somehow all-controlling, that he's influencing Europe, everybody knows.
I totally disagree with that. George Soros is the
biggest... It's not something to disagree with, because it is an anti-Semitic trope.
George, that's just because you stated doesn't mean it's true.
The idea that George Soros is controlling the world is massive.
I didn't say control of the world. I said he's the financier and back of the NGO.
So you're unaware that many people will read that as being a nod and a wink toward anti-Semitism?
Absolutely not. I don't see that at all.
Experts in Italy will connect the success of the Italian far right and say this is connected to a really alarming resurgence of neo-fascism in Italy right now. I mean, that has been...
It doesn't exist.
I don't know.
What doesn't exist?
They built all this story about the fascism was coming back, so to alarm people, so they were voting for the left. You know what? You should come in Italy and look at what we are doing every day.
Okay, let me ask about your party secretary, Francesco Minutilu. He had a manifesto, an objection to Islamic people. He said Adolf Hitler was his uncle, and that fascism was, quote, the best period in Italian history.
It can be that you have got somebody that says something you don't agree. Maybe we changed him.
This is not right.
You're an interpreter, not an interviewee, so if you don't mind.
I will give you after my opinion.
We're not interested in your opinion right now.
But hang on, don't be so rude to this guy. You don't have permission to be rude to him.
I'm only talking, I just met him 1 hour.
I understand.
Your way of interviewing is fascist.
Sir, with respect, your way of translating is highly ineffective. We're having a conversation. If you wouldn't mind, would like to continue. Georgia, you said your party was not neo-fascist. Steve, when you told me you were going to meet George, you described Brothers of Italy as a neo-fascist party.
I don't think I did.
You did, twice.
I don't think I did.
So I just wonder who's right. Is it not a neo-fascist party or it is? Because that's what you said to me.
I don't think I did at all. You can't possibly believe those are dog whistles. You can't possibly believe those are dog whistles.
Do you know, I think you... I genuinely don't think you could not believe that they are.
Oh my God, yeah. Come on, dude.
Yeah. And I don't sort of think it's a trivial sort of jokey thing, and you do the sort of smirk, and it's sort of uncomfortable for me, because it's serious.
Oh, I did, but I think...
It's serious offensive dog whistle.
Oh my, I think...
You know it's stupid.
No, I think you're totally wrong on that. You know you're wrong.